So here are some of the most earlier forms of coins. So number one, it is the Pittas coins. Over here, number two, these are the Portuguese coins. Number three, we've got the gold dinars, real gold. Four, you've got gold coins from Kelantan. I don't know what that is, but it looks like little pieces of metal just curled up. Number six, you have the Chinese money with the squares in the middle and different sizes. And you have number seven, the coin from Tarangano. Sorry, number seven is from Kelantan. Number eight is from Tarangano. And number nine, you have the coin from Perak. Halo Indra. Let's have a look over here. What do we have over here? So it says the conversion of Islam to Islam of the ruler of Malacca by Sayyid Abdul Aziz, a religious scholar from Jeddah and one of ours. This event was the first step that led ultimately to Malacca's becoming a great center for the dissemination of Islam, re-owned throughout archipelago. So this must be the leader or the king of Malacca, which is interesting. Their traditional clothes is very similar to what the Arabs were wearing. It's probably just gold because he's the king. And then you've got the Sahaba here and one of his young followers. Very interesting. So on the map here you can see that's where Malacca is. We got across, we got Brunei up to Mindanao. I hope I pronounce it right. Mindanao. And over here, we have one of the earliest forms of the Quran. So that's Surah Al-Rahim. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim. So in the name of God, most merciful, most magnificent, all praise is due to the Lord of all the worlds. It's another old Quran. It says here, the handwritten Malay Quran was originated from Java Island in Indonesia and written on European paper. There is a small note in Pagon, the Pagon script, on the large page of the Quran which states, the Mus'haf copy is the property of Hajja Zainab. So you can see the size of the Quran is, mashallah, very beautiful. Looks like a lot of effort went into it. So over here, number six, we've got a traditional instrument. It's called the ribab. So the ribab is a string instrument played in the band accompanying traditional Kelantanese shows called Ma Yang, Main Puturi and Tuk Samalapit. This ribab is about 80 years old. Looks like it's made from some sort of animal skin. So it's a Malay warrior, Hang Tao. He's a great warrior that must have been very good in hand-to-hand combat. These are the shields. Over here, number 7. So this is the vest that was used by Bugis warriors in the 18th century. It is made from pieces of buffalo horn held together with iron rings. Interesting. There's the shields and the swords. Sandang was a weapon used especially by the Bugis and the men of Sulu in the southern Philippines in the 18th century. It was used for slashing like a sword. The blade is straight with waves like that of a kris and made of wrought iron. The hilt is copper and there is a sheath. Nowadays a sandang would be one of the items in a set of royal insignia. This is interesting. So sandang or suluk is a kind of kris with a broad blade. It is particularly a weapon of choice for the men of Sulu. The hilt of a sandang is unlike that of other kris. It is cylindrical but designed to prevent it slipping from the user's grip by a hooked end piece. That is huge. I can't picture the size of the man to use that.
It's a replica.
Is that a replica, is it? Oh, so the actual size, this is the real size over here.